Monet De Haan is one of the main characters of the show Gossip Girl 2021, who is known for her power and striking looks. She most embodies the nuances of the original Gossip Girl era into the modern age. She is passionate, cunning, elegant, and confident in nature, with a regal, polished, preppy, and daring style that commands the room just as she does. Hailing from old New York money, she is modern royalty, the daughter of pharmaceutical moguls Camille and Grayson De Haan, but strives to pave her own path in the world, without any desire to follow in her family's footsteps. With her eyes on the prize at all times, Monet is the ultimate queen bee of the show. Despite not being the face of her friendship power trio, she is the one who pieces together the image, develops plans at a moment's notice, and sets the itinerary. Monet has natural power, understands garnering influence, and is the mastermind, serving as a PR consultant to her friend Julian. Alongside their friend Luna, Monet's partner in scheming, Monet is skilled at not just piecing together moments, but has a keen eye, the skilled ability to recognize quality, and is sharp with details. This applies to all parts of her life, from schemes and planning posts to events and style. An example of a look that encapsulates this is when she sports the Lioness Fontana blazer in blue, a Tory Burch chain trim mini skirt, a Louis Vuitton monogram heart bag, and finishes off the ensemble with a camera hanging around her neck that she keeps on her at all times, as well as a rhinestone bow tie choker. Throughout time, the meaning and symbolism of chokers have evolved greatly. A standout chapter of history that relates to chokers of high adornment is during the Victorian era, when fashion and jewelry evolved dramatically in relation to status and trends. Alexandra of Denmark had a slight scarring on her neck and reignited this choker trend that many Victorian women of high caliber began to match to their tiaras and brooches, even if the accessory was not traditionally to be worn. Monet opts for chokers and bow adornments to the neck that usually would not be styled in this manner. It's a nod to queen status, but not so overtly with something mirroring a tiara, but one of quiet confidence that is very knowing. Though not the quote-unquote queen of her group, it is evident that Monet is behind the operations. Traditionally, this type of character is the one in the spotlight. She flaunts her power and, when is in the mood, rules with an iron fist. But Monet, unlike many queen bee types, is not set on overall rule. With her looks, resources, eye for visuals, and assertive demeanor, one may think that Monet would take on a social role that is higher in ranking, but instead she chooses herself to opt for the side role. She does not covet the spotlight, but rather directs where the spotlight goes.
Okay, now, that, like everything but your outfit, was carefully chosen. The way the light hits, the proximity to the trash, the fact that people have to uncomfortably turn their head to the left to take us on. Okay, so experience is arrival, first day, junior year. So just back up a little bit.
Her public relations knowledge and skill set allows her to control the narrative. She is rather looking into the future. With her eyes set on an internship, Monet hones her skill set and expertise to be who she wants to be, with a firm grip on who she is in the present. In the first look, she sets the tone with her statement, Balmain look, as the mission statement of Balmain goes, to always dress women in the right look for the right moment. We see how her fashion is always suited to and goes beyond the moment that she is in, to capture her aura, command without speaking, and visually project. I've gone over the specific details such as the brands and meanings of this look in the video, the psychology of how you dress and first impressions, a style analysis of the first episode. Monet's character is captured in her first on-screen presentation, by which she sits at her dining table, mirroring the dynamic she has with Luna and Julian, but it's very evident she is in charge. Julian reaches out and looks to her for guidance on what to wear, and she dismisses the suggestion, by which Luna takes direction and compliments both Julian and Monet, and ensures a picture-perfect moment for Julian. This is very telling of their group dynamic. Monet has a deep understanding of power and the nature of people, and social stratification. This is the concept that people are ranked in differing hierarchies, while some are to be considered more important, influential, and powerful than others. Typically, these groupings are based more on socioeconomic factors or cultural traits that are cherished, such as wisdom or beauty. But this is a modern high school ecosystem, so it is a bit less nuanced, although these factors are still present to some extent and play a role. The cultural beliefs of the ecosystem reinforce the groupings. In Monet's case, she sees how Julian seeks influence. She also sees Julian's effect on people, and the traits that Julian has are, by societal standards, admirable. Her and her close friend Luna have differing knowledge. Both possess strong skill sets that complement one another. They together form a friendship that, in traditional media and culture tropes, is best known as the power trio. But their dynamic falls into the Freudian trio. The specific type of trio contains two foil characters and one balance. The three characters psychologically operate in positions that, in psychoanalytic theory, are the three parts of the human psyche. Because they have one another, their individual traits that differ grow to be more prominent and powerful because they keep one another in line. Each of the girls' respective styles and are very representative of their nature. The id will lean towards chaotic nature, more cold with logic, blunt and straightforward.
You as someone who loses is bad for business. I didn't lose anything.
And everything will be fine so long as you win.
Hence the proper regal and daring looks. The superego will adhere to lawful nature, with high focus on internalized morals or ideals. Hence the sporty and trendy looks. And the ego will have the most neutral nature that strives to please the id's desires in a realistic and socially appropriate manner that suits the superego. Luna, the one with the more ethereal, mostly neutral palette, accommodates both, creating the equilibrium.
We love you.
But we are appalled.
Vulnerability is the disease of the masses, right? You're royalty, strong, indestructible, and attainable.
Oh, I'm definitely that.
Did she just turn down Vogue?
There was no Vogue. Just wanted to see how far gone she really was.
Their ensembles differ greatly. Monet has the most elevated, decadent looks out of the group that are rooted in high fashion, not in just a modern trendwear manner, but one that is rooted in heritage and prestige from fashion powerhouses such as Chanel, Gucci, Valentino, etc. Her personality dictates the eras by which a piece is preferable. For example, Monet is noted to favor old world Chanel for evening wear, is noted to prefer vintage high fashion from brands such as Versace. Though socially savvy, Monet does not follow the status quo of classics or trends, opting for fashion that is regally rooted, yet fashionable and dynamic. She has more youthful looks for events, but this undertone is still present. An example of this is in the first episode, where she attends a fashion show sporting a Christopher John Rogers purple-cropped double-breasted blazer and pleated cropped trouser suit. She loves to make a statement in a power suit moment, an ensemble that embraces intellect, strength, and vigor with a strong feminine edge. Her staple garments include mini skirts, bodysuits, oversized sweaters, heels, and blazers, as well as bows, chokers, or neckties as common accessories. Monet is also very fond of print play. Her outfits have a strong sense of style, and she has the confidence to mix prints, patterns, and textures that furthers her visual dominance without overwhelming the eye. For example, the Eugenia Kim Sabrina Wool Baker Boy cap that is adorned with mixed finished chains, including crystals and a strand of pearls. Pairing this with a plaid bomber wool blend jacket, her wide range of mind is captured in her ability to apply a wide range of embellishments. Embellishments are never worn in a garish manner. They are always well suited to her. She wears the piece, not vice versa. Her use of logos is minimal, and she implements them more often as an accent rather than a focal point. For example, in episode 3, the Chanel bow brooch and belt, though the notable Chanel motif of the double C is on display, elevating and bringing personality to an outfit, as well as drawing the eye around the look. In this specific case, The bow brooch not only abides by the dress code, but creates a further display of the face, hinting at that regal status, while the belt highlights the waist and brings together the ensemble, while creating accents and momentum and suit Monet's magnitudes. She herself is very aware of her versatility, independence, and competitive nature. Unlike many in a sidekick role, she is not dependent on Julian, but does need Julian in line.
All those years of work for nothing when it could have been Suri? It could have been Zahara. I can't end up working with my mom in biotech. I just can't.
Don't worry.
Many of her looks have similar silhouettes, pieces, and tones that remain in the realm of Ivy League style. An elegance and cultivated, quieter confidence. I've gone in depth on this style of dress and the guide to preppy and Ivy League style, wardrobe curation, women and menswear edition, if you're interested in this specific type of fashion. She maintains a regal color palette, but pushes boundaries with the execution of her looks. She does not need to create dominance through her clothing, but rather creates an equal amount of dominance to her magnetic and strong presence. Her clothing is an extension of herself. When she dresses up, her clothing displays personality rather than projecting or conjuring up traits that are not there. For example, in episode 2, she wears a Rosario strapless, ruffled, and velvet gown, paired with an embellished velvet envelope clutch and a Chanel choker with minimal heels. The look is glamorous and superior in nature through the use of fabric and construction, but it is also very self-assured and captures her constant balancing act of nature. She is glamorous, charming, and powerful, but controls this.
What are you waiting for? Go inside. Fire the silver bullet.
No.
What do you mean, no?
I'd always say no.
Well, yeah, because it's gross.
You don't understand.
Unlike many in the sidekick role, Monet is not completely dependent on Julian. Monet has natural power, an effortless dominance that trumps this entire dynamic. But when Julian begins to challenge this, the id, ego, and superego power struggle of nature begins. When her work is cast aside and no longer appreciated, feeling that this cannot be salvaged, Monet decides to take her future back into her own hands, rather than relying by any degree on Julian.
As soon as Jules is back on top, we'll be too.
With Julian's rejection of all they have built together, and Luna feeling betrayed, there is a lack of mediating. Monet decides to take her talents and skills elsewhere, which concludes Monet's storyline in part 1.
The world is bigger than Constance, Julian.
I thought you were my friend.
I thought you were mine too. I don't want to do things the way that we've always done it. Luna may not care, but this
I already have an agent at LGA, so.
But this is my future.
Which concludes Monet's storyline in part 1. From this, we can see Monet's strong will and presence as one that is not just exerting power, but is power that can be channeled in numerous ways. Her intelligence and skills are sharp as her looks. She is not one to back down and cast aside her goals, or to have her work undervalued. Her curation skills are not only applied to Julian with Luna, but this is present in her lifestyle and fashion. The restrained opulence offers the nature of true regality without obvious implications through conscious prosperity and power that's about to be unleashed. If you're interested in a part 2 video on Monet's character and style development, once released, please let me know in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please subscribe, like, turn on notifications, and comment. Thank you so much for watching.